Hello everyone and welcome back to the Keep Productive YouTube channel. It is Francesco here. In this feature, we're diving into Infinity. We're going to give you a quick review of this application and also dive into some of the features so that you guys can go away and check it out for yourselves. So I'm very excited today because this has been a requested one. I've seen a lot of this stuff on social media in terms of people mentioning Infinity, and I thought it'd be a good opportunity to pause for a minute and explore it. Now, I've currently got access to the early access of this application, so it's currently in beta. It does plan to launch. I will guide you through some of the pricing when they plan to launch, because they sent an email about that, so you guys can get all you need to know about pricing near the end. But let's just dive into some of the features. So we are here on startinfinity.com, and you can apply for early access if you want to. Now, it's hard to sort of vocalize what Infinity does. So Infinity is an Airtable-like application that allows you to manage your projects, very similar to the likes of Trello. So it's a sort of like if Trello and Airtable had a baby. It's currently really early in the progress, but you can create boards and turn them into lists, calendars, Kanban, of course, and a table view. It has a range of folder navigation, and you can add a range of attributes to each of the cards that you create. So I will be diving into it today. It's currently in beta, so if there are any discrepancies in like the design, we'll be viewing on web, so just bear that in mind. Okay, so let's dive over to the access account. So this is the dashboard. So we're actually going to be checking out the beta edition. So guys, just before we dive in, a big thank you to Missive for sponsoring this month here on the Keep Productive YouTube channel. I will talk to you about Missive, which is a team collaboration email application, which can be used for teams and solo individuals. And we will be talking about them a little later in this feature. So guys, this is the sort of dashboard that you get when you sign up for an Infinity account, and you can go and through the early access, but again, you're gonna have that sort of a couple of weeks away from launch. So you can create what's called a workspace, and essentially when you create a workspace, you've got a brand new area. It's very similar to Trello boards in allowing you to create different teams for the different boards that you access. So in this case, you can see that I've created an area called demo, and you can see the demo boards are available here. So you can access, of course, the boards that you've got inside there, the team access. It's very similar to Trello, so you can invite other team members and you can change the team logo, of course, delete it and modify it. So here we are. Let's go into the clients area. I created this demo board from some of the templates that you can use to essentially manage client data. So for example, here we go. This is a client overview sheet. You've got obviously over on the left-hand side some of the navigation. So you can see there's two folders. There's the lead pipeline and the closed clients. So these are the clients that have been successful. And you can see that these are the ones that are in the pipeline. So what's cool about this is, first off, you get quite a nice design. As I said, it looks very similar to Airtable in a way. You've got the ability to obviously move stuff between. This is a Kanban setup, but naturally you can change this. So for example, if I want to go ahead and create a new area, you can create a view type. So for example, in this case, maybe I wanted to see this data as a list. So if I went ahead and created it as a list, you should be able to see that appear there. And you can add brand new entries here really easily. Now, just going back to that tab area, again, it works very similar to Airtable. You can create a new view type. You've got the columns, which is what we've used here. They're also known as Kanban. The calendar view. So for example, if I wanted to see it in calendar view, of course, none of the data in there actually relates to a date attribute. So that's the only problem. And you've also got a table view. So if I wanted to see it in a table view using the columns as a way to organize, then I can do so. So as you can imagine, you do get all the detail on that right-hand side. But if I went to list view and clicked in, you can see all of the attributes associated to the bay view deal. And you can see the folder that it's part of. If I wanted to go ahead and create a new folder, it obviously creates a brand new area, which is really easy to do so. And naturally, you'll be able to add a list, column, calendar, or table straight up. And obviously, that's new data once you add a brand new folder. So they have stated here that they are coming soon will be a gallery view, allowing you to see more of a, so I guess it's like the gallery view in Notion, a timeline view, which is probably like the monday.com timeline, and chart view instead. So that's a nice bit of knowledge there about what's coming soon to this experience. So let's look at the attributes again. You obviously have the ability to edit all of the attributes that are added and add any attributes if you want to. So for example, in this case, they've tagged the amount. You can actually go ahead and edit this. You can change the property type, very similar to Notion, to arrange different things from a checkbox, date, number, text, and long text. But there's also a checklist ability, which is quite useful if you and your team want to create a little subtask list. You can add members, which are similar to the likes of Notion. You can add attachments and labels. So essentially that's tags. You've got links, emails, and phone, which is useful if you're building your own CRM or a sales database. And you can even create, like, for example, a reference or even what time it was created at or who it was created by and the source folder as well. So you do have the ability to go in real detail. You can actually change the formatting per one anyway. So this is quite a good little addition. If I wanted to as well, I could add a tag that's pre-created and naturally it will move based on that. So for example, if I go ahead and delete it in lead in, it actually disappears. The Bayview deal disappears from there. But if I went and added it in contact made, you'd see it appears in this section here. So of course the attributes are sorted based on, of course, filtered and grouped by the stage, which is quite useful. So we'll show you that in a second. You can obviously go to comments and add any comments if you're working on a team. I quite like this view because it adds the ability to comment, but in a bit more of a structured way versus the likes of, say, Notion. And of course, Airtable has a similar feature to this. They also have an activity log. So for example, you saw there I made an update to the stage. It will obviously be logged as an activity and all of your team can naturally do that. Now, just remove this intercom. You can see here, obviously, I can move around like I would. I can add a new label, which obviously would update everything. So for example, if I went ahead and went, proposal needs review or reviewing, and moved it across to this section and dragged one of these in. If I go to that attribute, it can see that it's changed the stage automatically, but doesn't change all the other details, which is quite good. So that's how you sort it. Obviously, this is grouped by stage at the moment, so you can group it by country if you want to. So these are the deals based on the country, US, United States, and Australia. You've also got the amount, so leads by amount. So for example, these leads will be $6,500 dollars in this case. So you can group it by the different areas. And for example, if I wanted to go ahead and create a brand new tab, created it in the same column view, but I wanted to base it on something else like client, like what client I'm working with. In the moment, it doesn't actually have any ones associated to it, but you have ones pre-created. So for example, they're onboarded. So maybe I want to say they're onboarded, we've retained that person. And you can go over to the areas and naturally it's created a new area, which is a client area. And naturally you can move them across there. So this is great for if you're looking to create a view, group them by different attributes and really organize data in a bit more of a traditional fashion. So if I go to closed clients, obviously this is a table view. It's very similar. So for example, if you wanted to open up a entry on that table, you can do, and naturally it has all of the pieces here. And this is a good demonstration of the date abilities. So for example, if I went and added the dates that they needed to be communicated by, then of course I can see a tally of that. And that is great if I want to go ahead and create a new view for the calendar view. You can see that all of these are pinned out, and of course I can go and edit them there. Now this view only shows the month view, I believe. So you can go and use some filter ability. So for example, if I wanted to filter based on the company name or the amount, actually just say the client that you're using, and you can select one of them. So the only ones that are obtained, okay, Google looks like the only ones that are obtained, they're the upcoming meetings for that. So as you can imagine, it's a good way to be able to organize that. And it also states the table view here, and you can actually flip it if you want to really quickly into another such view. Now you can use the customization abilities to actually toggle some of these on or off. So if I wanted to get rid of some fields, I could do so or add them back in, which is something that's really easy to do. Now, of course, you can create these boards for any type of area that you've got. And of course, you can go back to the board section. There's a little panel that comes up if you want to go ahead and search. But if you want to just go back to my database, you'll be able to find everything there. If I want to do, I could create a brand new board. So let's say I want to go ahead and create an editorial calendar. And make it private. So at the moment, I want to keep it private. You can give it a bold color and invite existing members or external members that are not part of anything. And you can give them access either as a team member. I believe it's a board member and an admin member. So you can add more people. Now, the great thing is you can import from the likes of Trello, or you can import from, for example, a Kanban board. So you can set up a columns based on a Kanban board, a gallery, sales pipeline, notes, or bookmarks. Basically, these are templates to get you started. So in this case, I'm going to go with the content calendar, and it's going to start populating it as a content calendar. So it automatically gives you a few of them. If I wanted it to go ahead and delete these, I think I'd have to manually go into the top right-hand corner and get rid of them, which is a bit of a pain. But again, if I wanted to get started, this would be quite useful. So obviously, I've got a good design, and it's pre-created a Kanban board as well as a calendar. So that's quite useful, especially if you want to go ahead and create a brand new design. So if I want to go ahead and create, for example, like, okay, we got a piece on Google Tasks versus Microsoft To Do, then you could do so. And you can add a featured image. So for example, in this case, I could go down here. So in this case, I'm just going to drag this one on. Obviously, it's not the right one, but you can see here the image is brought in pretty well. So for example, if I change the title to TickTick 5.0 launch, and I went, okay, I'm going to choose a publish date. I can go down here and add a date to it. Now, in this case, the only member is myself, so I'm going to access that. But at the moment, that's a great way to view everything. If I go over to calendar view, of course, it's been added there, which is quite nice. Now, you've got search up here, which is really easy to do. You've got theme color. So this is quite nice. You can change the theme based on, you know, whatever you like, really. And you can access the activity log for the total access to this board. So up in the top right-hand corner, I can access my own profile, etc., but I can share stuff as well with friends. So for example, all I have to do is copy the code. They get exclusive early access and earn $9 in credit for each person that brings into Infinity. So that's one of the bonuses right now. I believe it's still in beta. So guys, obviously it is a free application at the moment. There's early access. I wanted to give you a bit of information which they sent over in terms of pricing. Hopefully it gives you the right outline. So from the email I got, they mentioned that Infinity was only a few weeks away from the official launch. And once Infinity exits the beta stage, there will be a free 14-day trial, whilst the pricing will be $9 per month per user billed monthly, or $6 per month per user billed annually. So that's one of the big bonuses. I guess it's relatively priced as any of these are, but of course, there is no free experience, which is a bit of a pain. Now, if you are on the beta, they will give you $500 in Infinity credits, which is equal to 5 years of free use for one member. So obviously you can use it to yourself for that period of time. So just before we dive into my final thoughts on Infinity, I wanted to let you know about Missive, which is a really powerful email application. If you are using it for a team, it's perfect because you can assign different emails to other people, and you can also add comments, chat in a room about emails that are coming up, and even draft features too. You can assign tasks to each other, which is perfect. And what's amazing about Missive is that you can use all of the powerful abilities like read receipts, send later, automation, rules, and API setup. It is really extensive. I use it as my personal email, and I highly recommend it. The one thing I wanted to pass on to you guys is to actually check it out in the description below, and also to check out the Missive tour that I've done. It's an unbiased tour of what I think of the application at the moment, so you can check that one out in the description below. So guys, Infinity, I have a good feeling about this application. It's super early stages, and if I guess it launched with these features, I'd say it's a little bit overpriced for what it is compared to applications like Airtable, for example. I do like the fact that you can be very flexible, very collaborative with it, and it works very well. And the good thing is it looks really attractive, and I think I probably missed out a few features in this quick review, but at the moment, I think it's very lightweight. I don't think it's too bulky. I think they need to add a lot more views and a lot more integrations as well to make it really amazing. But I do think it's a good resource. That's no doubt about it. But I think it's got plenty of time to bed into that experience. And what I quite like about it is that it is a new application, and if you definitely beta tested it, you're gonna get a few bonuses in there. So do check it out in the link in description if you're interested. Of course, I'll give you my opinions once it's fully launched and maybe a couple of weeks into launch, but I do think it's in between the likes of Trello and Airtable, and it's not quite at Airtable stage yet, but it's definitely on its way. So guys, I look forward to some of your thoughts in the comments. Feel free to pop them there. Make sure to check out Missive, and a big thank you for stopping by today. Hit subscribe, like, and do comment below. Thank you very much, guys. I'll see you guys in a future video. Cheers.